gonna build you a house. And you know, people who are on house arrest, they have little things on their ankles. And when they go out past the distance they're supposed to go, then something goes off, and whoever's watching them and keeping a watch over them, it goes off and it goes back. And they try to find out where they are. And so I say this, Seminary was on under surveillance. He was on house arrest, you know, but when he changed and went out where he shouldn't go, and, you know, he was destroyed, and that's what happens to us. Somebody might have in their mind that they're going to leave the house of the Lord and go back doing what they want to do. Somebody might even go back into the world, but I tell you, that's not the way to go. If you have a problem, stay in the house of the Lord, and may God bless you. I want to tell you a story about this lady named Rahab in the second chapter of the book of Joshua. When Joshua sent two spies out to Jericho, amen, to spy out the land, and somehow the king got word of it. I don't know how the king got word of it. The Bible doesn't say. And so the king sent men to Rahab and asked Rahab, where are the two spies? And Rahab said, they were here, but they're gone. I don't know what happened. If you chase after them, then you can find them. So somehow Rahab and the two spies got a chance to converse with each other. And Rahab said, okay, I've done you all a favor. I helped you. Now I want you to help me. And so Rahab said, I want you to help me, but not me alone, but help my father also and his family and so on. And so they told her, we will help you. But when we come to take the city, you must remain in the house. You must remain in the house, because if you remain out of the house, then we're not responsible for what happened to you. We have to remain in the house of the Lord. Some people, I don't understand, some people just come just because they want to come. But that is a place to come to serve the Lord, to give God glory and honor for what he has done. Amen. To find a way so that God can help our soul and that he will bless us. And in the house of the Lord yields a place, because the way things are going now, if there were ever a time to serve God, it is now. If there were ever a time to be in God's house, it is now. If there were ever a time to be real, it is now. Because God is there. All we have to do is seek him while he may be found. The time is going to come when people will wish that they had sought the Lord. But it's going to be too late. I want to serve him now while I can find him. I want to serve him now while he is here. Amen. Praise the Lord. Not in a building will work. Not in the place you go is good enough. It is not good enough. So what we have to do is let the Lord be our guide and let him teach us and let him guide us through the word of God. And I know if we trust God, he will do just that. The Bible tells us in the book of St. John, the 14th chapter, let not your heart be troubled. You don't have to be troubled. If you believe in God, also believe in me. In my Father's house, there it is again, the house. In Jerusalem, there are many mansions for the people of God. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, are we ready to stay in God's house? It might be on somebody's mind to go back, but let me take you back. If you go back, you're going to suffer. Things are going to get worse. You're going to wish you could make it, but my God, my God, if we have an opportunity now to stay with God, we should seek that opportunity and pursue it, because in the house of God, you can get deliverance. In the house of the Lord, if you need it, God's got it. If you want it, God's got it. Amen. If you need deliverance, God's got it. If you need strength so that the people that are working with you or the young people, your peers that give you trouble, God's got the answer. He's got whatever you need. You can find in the house of the Lord. You can find him there. He will be there. He's always there, stretched out with his arms that come to me. All you that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Don't just learn of anybody, but learn of Jesus. And I can tell you something. I'm not saying it's trying to get any brownie points or anything, but I tell you, man, when my wife told me, she said, honey, I found a church. And the man is preaching. And she said, he's preaching the word. We've been around for a long time. He's preaching. I can't wait to get there. You see, we were in a place where we know the Lord had sent us to this particular place. Look. And when we went to this place, you had the women looking beautiful. I mean, they were all beautiful, tall, down, looking nice. The men had the nice suits on and everything. You had elders in the pulpit, ministers in the pulpit. You had the bishop in the pulpit. They were all looking good, but they didn't have anything on the inside.
Amen.
They were elders. They were ministers. Bishops, but I'm telling you the truth, they didn't have anything. They were in the house, but they didn't have nothing in their house. You understand what I'm saying? They were in the building, but they didn't have anything inside them. And so the Lord had made the gave an opportunity to speak, and I preached about the Holy Ghost. And the bishop liked it for a while, and then his son began to tell him this and tell him that. You see, the sons of Samuel, they weren't like Samuel. And just because it's your son, that doesn't mean that's who God wants you to put there. But praise the Lord, you gotta have, sometimes people do it, you know, to help them to continue on the ministry or the legacy or whatnot. But his son didn't like it, so I had to preach that thing. I had to teach that thing about the Holy Ghost. And so this is what they believe. You get down on your knees, you say, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah. Then they get up and say, I got the Holy Ghost. They were saying, as long as they confess it, they had it. You can confess what you want. That doesn't mean you have it. Amen. You have to get it. Amen. Lord have mercy, Jesus. So we were telling them, and the bishop got up behind me and said, you don't speak in tongues as the Spirit of God. He said, you don't speak in unknown language. He said, you speak English when you speak in tongues.
My.
He was telling the congregation that you speak English. So he said, you know, I want you to have my license, and I want you to have my card. I said, I have one, I don't need another. He said, I want you to have mine, so I got it, right? And then I found out, he wanted me to be like them. He wanted me to take their side because the people were really against what they were standing for. But I took the Bible side.
Amen.
Because I'm in the house, born into the house. I'm not just in any building. You could go to some other church, but your heart is in the Word and the Holy Ghost is in you. You are in the house. Yeah, right. You are in the house. You've been born into the house.
Right.
Yeah. So he didn't like it. So y'all ain't gonna believe this. He got this big, tall man to come into church to beat me up.
Oh, my.
And so the minister elder was calling me to elders, but I don't think you should come. I said, you know what? They say, because he got somebody here that the bishop set up for you. I said, I'm coming anyway. So I came. I'm going to make it short. So I came. I went to church. And I saw him. He said to the bishop, you want me to go ahead and do what you have me to do? He said, no, wait, no, no. So I looked around, and the big guy went to the bathroom and washed his face. I went and washed my face also. But I didn't know he was in there. I stepped up in there. I saw this big dude in there. I was like, oh, Lord. I said, oh Lord. But then he looked at me. He said, Elton, come on in. He said, I don't know what the bishop was talking about. He said, when I hear you speaking about the word, you ain't saying that wrong. You want to say what the word said. I was like, thank you, Jesus. And so I washed my face. I had one eye open, looked at him, but he was so big. So he said, come on, let's walk down. Let's walk down to the chapel. So you know what I did? With my crazy self, he said, come on. He walked beside me, man. I knew I had it to me. I was walking with my head up in the air, and the bishop was looking. Oh, man, he got up and grabbed that guy, took him in the room, and said, why did you do what I told you to do? You were supposed to do this and that. You up here walking with him down the aisle. You were supposed to do that. And man, I was happy. I was happy. The Lord would deliver. If you stay in the house of the Lord, there is nothing that God won't do for you. If you be followers of that which is good, who shall harm you? But we have to stay in the house of the Lord. There is deliverance in God's house. There is protection in God's house. If you go outside and start running around, going from place to place, you're going to come back with all kinds of questions. You're going to come back with all kinds of mess, and you will never be delivered if you keep doing that. But if you stay in the house of the Lord, ye shall be saved. You shall be delivered. God will bless you. He will be the strong tower. He will be your deliverance. He will be your fortress. He will be whatever you want him to be, as long as you trust him in the house. Trust the Lord. It doesn't matter how bleak it may look. It may look like there's no light at the end of the tunnel. Trust God anyway. You may be going through a pain in your body. You might have missed somebody in your family. But trust God. God will deliver you. God will deliver them. God will fix everything. Stay in the house of the Lord. And it doesn't matter what comes. It doesn't matter what goes. It doesn't matter what people say. God will deliver and deliver on time.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to tell you about another house. Glory to God. That John saw. Hallelujah. The first heaven and the first earth was passed away. And there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. Don't you want to go? I want to go, and I am willing to deal with whatever I have to deal with, and I am willing to stay in the house because there is safety in the house, there is salvation in the house. God will bless you, your children, your mother, your father, your wife, your son, if we stay in the house and let God be first in our lives. Hallelujah. He will do it. If we just trust him, if we just believe him, he will do it. He'll fix that husband. He'll fix that wife. He'll fix whatever the situation is. God will bless. When you're in the house, God will honor his people. He will hear their call. He will hear their cry. All we have to do is stay in the house and be right. Do your best to live as holy as you can. Be as right as you can in the eyesight of God. And God will honor that. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord, I'm done. Amen. We're going to turn it back into the hands of Bishop Copeland. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I enjoyed that. Amen. Stay in the house. Reminds me of a message Bishop O.C. Jones preached from Rochester. I forget where we were. It might have been in Columbus, Ohio, I believe. But he preached a sermon, "Take Me to Church." Praise the Lord. Regardless of what's going on in your life, take me to church. When people stay away from church, they do themselves a terrible disservice. Because all these spirits start attaching themselves to you. The next thing you know, you won't even know which end is up. Amen. Thank God. Stay in the house. The Apostle Paul, when they were on the sea and a storm arose called Euroclydon. Amen. And it was violent. It was tearing the ship to pieces. And the Bible says that they began to throw stuff off the ship and feared for their lives. But Paul said, "An angel of the Lord stood by me at night, whose I am and whom I serve. And he told me not one soul is going to be lost." He said, "But I got one word for you. Stay on the ship." Praise the Lord. And that's what we have to do. Amen. Stay with the Lord. Stay in the house of the Lord. Seek the Lord. Praise the Lord. Love him. Amen. And the Lord will bless us if we stay in the house. God bless you today. Amen. Let's give the Lord praise again for that wonderful word. This time we're going to dismiss this session and we're going to break and come back in for morning worship. Did you lift the offering yet? Amen. Amen.